Here we are in Sayulita. We are two gay expats. I'm Trey.
And I'm Andy.
And we are going to go check out the beach here on a fabulous day trip from Puerto Vallarta.
Let's go.
All right, we made it to Sayulita. We're just walking into the central part of town now. The bus is a little crazy, actually. I'm sure that was not the tourist bus, but it was the green and white Compostela buses, which leave like super frequently from that Walmart depot. But yeah, they kind of stopped for pick up everyone for work, people with like umbrellas and inner tubes for the beach. It was pretty wild. But yeah, so we are headed to lunch now. We're like actually hungry already. So we are gonna head to this cute Italian eatery called La Rustica Sayulita. And I need a margarita, so. What were your thoughts?
Yeah, let's go get a margarita. That was a fascinating bus ride. Interesting.
Yeah, hopefully we can find the tourist bus on the way back that'll stop a little bit less than that one did. La Rustica was super good. We always search out a wood-fired oven, and they had amazing wood-fired pizzas, delicious salads. We had a nice Caesar salad, and they had great craft cocktails too. So definitely worth checking out if you are in Sayulita.
It was a really good margarita.
Yeah, oh yeah, feeling so good now. And we're gonna head now to check out the Flag Street here, the main street, and then head down to the beach. So here we go.
See.
One of the most popular things to do in Sayulita is to take photos underneath the canopy of colorful flags on Calle Delfines, or Slap Street as it's known locally. Legend has it, two men were involved in a heated argument over making changes to this famous street, which ended with one man slapping the other. And we could definitely see that happening again today with so many visitors jockeying to get that perfect selfie. Of course, the beach is the main draw here. On the walk to Sayulita's main beach, there are tons of cute shops and restaurants, as well as plenty of places to rent a surfboard. Surfing and backpacking are officially what put Sayulita on the expat map here. It's a beautiful sunny day on a beautiful beach in Mexico, so the main beach is absolutely packed. It's a rainbow of umbrellas for as far as we can see. It's so colorful. I really like it, actually. The main beach, though, is really crowded, so we're gonna head over to Los Muertos Beach and give that a try. Hopefully it's not as busy, but it probably is. It's like a holiday week, so it seems very, very busy. On the walk to Playa de los Muertos Beach, or Beach of the Dead, we realized so many names of our favorite beaches in Mexico and Spain are named for either love or death. In Sitges, for example, you'll find our favorite gay beach in Spain, actually, Playa del Muerto, or Beach of the Dead. And similarly named Playa Los Muertos here in Puerto Vallarta is the best gay beach. Be sure to check out both of those videos posted in the info card above. But we digress. It's a quick 10 to 15 minute walk from the center of Sayulita to Los Muertos Beach. On arrival, the beach is much quieter than the main beach, with local families and visitors alike enjoying the calm waters here. Boats are anchored offshore and kayakers are exploring the nearby coves. Speaking of which, there's an even more secluded small beach if you climb over the rocks to the right of Los Muertos Beach if you are looking at the water. It's definitely a hidden gem and a perfect spot to relax. All right, we are going to try to hike back to the main beach now along the rocks. It looks stunning. We see a couple other people doing it and thought it would be an interesting way to head back over to the main beach. It's absolutely stunning here on these rocks. We just saw some really cool, colorful crabs. And if you walk out a little further on the rocks, you'll find amazing views of the coastline as well as a number of beautiful birds just relaxing here offshore.
Oh, it's clearly feeding time for the pelicans.
Oh,
that's
yeah.
What they are, right?
It looks like it. Oh my gosh, they're totally diving for fish. This is so cool. There's so many of them. Look at this.
That's bananas.
He didn't get that one. Oh my gosh. It's starting to get a little cloudy now at the beach, so we're gonna walk back into town and head over to a beautiful bar called Cava and have one more drink before we head back to the bus depot and head to Puerto Vallarta.
Let's go.
Oh my gosh, we totally ended up in someone's backyard trying to get back to the main road, but we are back now and are headed back into town for that drink. On the way, we find more colorful street art, including this beautiful skull. We've been obsessed with skulls since arriving in Mexico. Cava is super cute. We love the rustic and relaxing vibe here. And since everyone is still at the beach, we have it all to ourselves. The watermelon mezcal cocktails are quite refreshing as well after the beach, and a perfect way to end our day trip to Sayulita. We are just headed back to the bus depot. We're almost there to get back to Puerto Vallarta, to the romantic zone. And we were just saying, like, oh my gosh, there's so many cute restaurants. It's so colorful, lots of great bars. We ran out of time, so we were like, you know, if you have the time, I would definitely say to stay here for at least one night, because I'm sure it gets a lot quieter after all the day trippers go home and you kind of will have an exciting evening, kind of like not all to yourself, but it'll be for sure less crowded. It's really busy in Sayulita, especially at this time of year during the holiday period. But yeah, it was a lot of fun. We're really glad we did it. And now we're excited to go back home and enjoy some AC and our little one.
Let's go walk our little one.
Hey, Pete.
To plan your own day trip to Sayulita, the easiest way to do it yourself is to just hop on any local bus in the romantic zone with Walmart written on the front, which will take you to the Marina Walmart. And from there, you can hop on one of the green and white Compostela buses that will take you onward to Sayulita. Sayulita is about 30 miles northwest of the romantic zone in Puerto Vallarta. It's just north of Banderas Bay in the neighboring Nayarit state. The cost is 10 pesos for the local bus and 50 pesos for the Compostela bus to Sayulita. So all in, about 60 pesos, which is just under $3 each way. From the Marina Walmart, the trip takes around an hour and a half, and the buses stop frequently along the route. They leave about every 20 minutes, if not sooner, from the Marina Walmart. Also, important to note, some of the buses have air conditioning and some of them do not, so you may decide to wait until the next one to make sure that your bus has AC. In retrospect, we should have taken an organized tour that includes both San Pancho as well as Sayulita, two amazing beach towns in Nayarit. We decided against it though because we wanted to have more time to explore, but in the end we lost so much time to transit. It was definitely around 2 hours each way for the local bus as well as the Compostela bus to get from the romantic zone to Sayulita. So if you have the time, we would definitely recommend Ubering up and staying overnight, or at a very minimum, to maximize your time, we would suggest taking an organized tour, as we underestimated the traffic into super popular Sayulita. Well, that's it for our amazing day trip from Puerto Vallarta over to Sayulita, Mexico. For more on our gay adventures, be sure to check out our website at 2gayexpats.com. Follow us on social media at 2gayexpats. And also, please smash that like button and subscribe to our channel. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you next time.
Hasta luego.